Remember this place? What's it have to do with this place? Stick around to discover 5 things you need to know about Arthur Treacher's. Be sure to subscribe and click the bell icon to set your notifications so you don't miss any of this juicy goodness. Hi gang, this is Troy. Welcome back to Restaurant Rewind. Today we take a closer look at Arthur Treacher's Fish and Chips, a chain that once boasted over 800 locations. Here are 5 things you need to know about Arthur Treacher's. Number 1, Arthur Treacher was a real dude, but not a restaurateur. Yes, of course there is a real Arthur Treacher, who was born in 1894 in England. He was an actor who many will remember as Jeeves the Butler and Constable Jones in Mary Poppins. At the time the chain was founded, Treacher was best known as the sidekick to Merv on the Merv Griffin Show. Arthur Treacher died on December 14, 1975 at age 81 from complications from heart disease. While he was the spokesperson for the chain, it's not exactly clear if Mr. Treacher had any financial investment in the chain or any real involvement in the food it served. Some claimed that the recipes were Arthur's own, but the man behind the brand and the recipes was actually Dennis Malin. More on him in just a bit. Number 2. Fish and Chips wasn't the first franchise to bear the Arthur Treacher name. About 1965, Arthur Treacher lent his name and his butler persona to a different franchise. It was called Call Arthur Treacher Service System, which was a household help agency that sourced local plumbers, painters, electricians, maids, babysitters, etc. to those who needed those services. It's funny because I wouldn't have guessed that his name carried that kind of weight, but apparently it did. Number 3. Arthur Treacher's has roots in Kentucky Fried Chicken. The franchise company was started in 1969 in Columbus, Ohio as National Fast Food Corp. National Fast Food had an interesting pedigree. Its leaders included 3 key people. S. Robert Davis, who was a real estate developer who built and leased several Kentucky Fried Chicken properties. L.S. Hartsog, who at the time ran a chain of bakeries selling biscuits to Colonel Sanders franchisees nationally. And of course, their friend, the legendary Dave Thomas, who had just sold his share in 4 Kentucky Fried Chicken franchises for $1.5 million. Dave departed National Fast Food just a few months after to found Wendy's. Number 4. There was a food war between the U.S. and England as to who invented fish and chips. Remember Dennis Malin from earlier? Mr. Malin came to the chain through the acquisition of Malin's of Bow, England. Yep, Bow. I had to look it up. Since about 1865, Malin's family had already been serving up a staple of fried fish with a side of fries, which of course are chips to our British friends. English folks thought that they invented fish and chips. Some in the U.S. thought we invented fish and chips. And the ads from Arthur Treacher's did nothing to clear up that dispute. Just like the Call Arthur Treacher service system, where the focus was the local community, Arthur Treacher's fish and chips ads in each locale seemed to convey that fish and chips were invented in their community, and that Arthur Treacher himself said so. So, for the record, it seems clear to me that fish and chips were developed in England. Case settled. Unless you guys have some other intel, in which case, share it in the comments below. So let's quickly recap. Here's the basic timeline. In 1865, Malin's of Bow began selling deep-fried fish wrapped in newspaper in London, England. Newspaper. How's that ink taste there, Bill? In 1969, Arthur Treacher's Incorporated acquired Malin's of Bow. It opened a restaurant in Columbus, Ohio, and immediately began franchising with National Fast Food Corp. Dennis Malin was brought on in charge of quality control. Things were getting exciting with fish and chips. Apparently, good news travels fast, really fast, because Arthur's was founded in April 1969, and within a few short months that very same year, at least 4 other brands sprung into existence. Long John Silver's, Captain D's, Skipper's, and Alfie's Fish and Chips, all aimed at capturing this new market. By 1970, there were 99 Arthur Treacher's units in operation. Fisher Foods purchased the rights to open 106 more units. In the early 1970s, competition was fierce, and Davis reorganized National Fast Food as Orange Co. Incorporated and began an aggressive expansion campaign, exploding the chain to 780 units. In order to make things enticing to investors, Davis set up long-term leases to guarantee lease payments even if the restaurants failed. One problem: competition was fierce and the market was flooded, and the restaurants did start to fail. In 1979, frozen fish purveyor Mrs. Paul's Incorporated acquired the chain. Sounds like a great thing, right? Well, not so much. With the chain already seriously struggling, the cod wars between the UK and Iceland caused cod prices to double. Wait a minute, I gotta focus on cod wars. That's it. Sorry. Well, Mrs. Paul's decided to switch from cod to pollock, which was inferior quality, and the move didn't sit well with customers or franchisees, who began to withhold royalty payments, claiming the lack of service. The franchisees sued and ultimately won, only Arthur Treacher's corporate had no way to pay. In 1982, franchisee Lumera Foods of America Incorporated acquired the business, but went bankrupt just a few short months later. Another group of investors bought the chain, but also went bankrupt just a few months after that. In 1984, a newly formed Arthur Treacher's Incorporated group acquired the 200-shop chain, went public, and later moved the home office to Jacksonville, Florida. Now, armed with a lot more cash, something the recent owners seemed to lack, I mean, come on, bankruptcy within a few months of the purchase? Twice? Takes a bit of cash to do these things. Anyway, things finally begin to restabilize, at least for a bit. In 2002, a subsidiary of True Foods purchased the Arthur Treacher's brand. In an interesting agreement, in 2006, Nathan's Famous bought the rights to market the Arthur Treacher's brand alongside its other brands, Kenny Rogers Roasters and Miami Subs. After all of this turmoil, it's easy to think that Arthur Treacher's fish and chips has succumbed to the competition and the not-so-great business decisions of the late 70s and early 80s, but the fifth thing you definitely want to know is Arthur Treacher's fish and chips lives on today. As of this recording, there are 7 remaining, 3 in New York and 4 in Ohio. Many locations have been co-branded with Nathan's Famous. Check out a site like Yelp if you plan to make a visit anytime soon, and if you do go, let me know how you like it. As a tribute to my British friends, I want to thank you for fish and chips. Okay, so I put the references for this video in the description. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel and click the bell so you don't miss anything. Please leave me a comment of what you want to see next, or just share a fond memory or two about your experiences with Arthur Treacher's. Love you guys, thank you for your support, and thank you for watching Restaurant Rewind. Sorry for the accent thing. It's just fun, and I can't help it.